Assalamualaikum and good morning to grade 6 students. We are doing chapter number 5 and we have studied that all around us, everything in this universe is made up of atoms and elements. See, element has small particles. These small particles are the unit of matter, right? These small particles are called atoms, right? It's a practical proof that everything around us is made up of atoms, and this is the study of scientists not for just one century, many centuries, right? Many thousand years have been taken to take out this analysis. Now, atoms, if atoms are same in a thing, then that is called element. If atoms are different in a thing, they are called mixtures or compounds. This is the theoretical model of atom. I want to tell you that these are the gold coins. If we melt these gold coins at very high temperature, the flames that are coming out of these, it is actually this type of atoms. And if we see them more under microscope, scanning tunneling microscope, they appear like this. Each and every matter is made up of 117 types of elements. The periodic table of element is shown in the right top of this picture. These are the 117 elements set in a table, right? So compounds and mixtures are the combination of these 117 elements. Periodic table is a tool for organizing elements. I want to tell you here a fact. Today, a Pakistani girl, Natalia Najaf, has broken a world record that she has said all the elements in just a record time, 117 elements in this periodic table. So you should be proud of it. And she is 9 years old. So all of you should try that you should learn this periodic table as well. We have studied already that mixtures are combination of many things, right? A mixture is made when two or more substances are combined, but their atoms do not join together. So metals, if are combined together, they form alloys. Stainless steel is a mixture of elements iron, carbon and chromium. Brass is a mixture of copper and zinc. Bronze is a copper and tin, while silver coins are copper and nickel. Here the rocks, seawater and sand on a beach, muddy water and smoke, all are mixtures. Now we will study uses of compounds. Compounds are those things which are formed when elements combine together, atoms combined together chemically. Materials such as compounds are far more common than pure elements. There are thousands of compounds around us. The vital material water is a compound of the element hydrogen and oxygen. Two atoms of hydrogen are combined with one atom of oxygen. Here red ball is oxygen and white balls are hydrogen. Keep in mind, this is just a model. It is actually made up of billions, trillions atoms. Today we have to do question number 6. Reading of page number 49. Second use of compound is plastic. A plastic bucket is made up of millions of carbon hydrogen atoms joined together in very long chains. Third use is blackboard chalk. Is a compound made from calcium sulfate and oxygen. The compound is called calcium sulfate and has the formula CaSO4. True chalk limestone is a compound of calcium carbon and oxygen. Its chemical name is calcium carbonate, CaCO3. Till now we have done question number 1 till 5. Today we will do question number 6. And question number 6 is, what are the differences between a compound and a mixture? Give 3 examples of each. Be ready with your blue marker, blue pen, pencil, journal, write day and date, and start writing the answer by pausing this video. A compound is a substance formed by the chemical combination of elements in fixed proportions. This is very important, fixed proportions. The number of atoms in molecules will always be one oxygen atom and two hydrogen atoms. It will not change. Common examples of compound include chalk or limestone, calcium carbonate, CaCO3 we have just studied, table salt, sodium chloride, NaCl we have studied in our previous lecture, washing soda, sodium carbonate, NaCO3, copper sulfate, CaSO4, and Epsom salt, magnesium sulfate. On the other hand, a mixture is a combination of two or more substances that have not reacted. Chemically is very important. It means that the atoms have not combined, have not made bond with each other, and can be separated using physical processes such as dissolving, distillation, evaporation, crystallization, etc., etc. Mixtures are not pure substances. Examples are air, soil, petroleum, and alloys of metals. Suppose the balls are atoms. So these are atoms of element. Suppose the balls are atoms, but these atoms are of compound. Here you can see the definition is written. Elements can have atoms or molecules. Mixtures are just the combination of these two things. Okay? But compounds are actually the combined bonded atoms or molecules. The definitions are also written. You can pause the video. You can learn these definitions as well. But question number 6 answer is enough that I have told you. That will be enough for your journal work. This is the classification. You can see pure substance has element atoms are same, compound atoms are different. Mixture is combination of many type of atoms, and this is just the mixed atoms, not combined, not bonded atoms. Mixtures can be homogeneous like water, mineral water, and it can be heterogeneous like ice cream. Okay, thanks for watching this video. Happy Independence Day, and become like Natalia Nijef. Allah Hafiz.